are taking a look at development of the digestive system. We are interested in the digestive system because a lot of disorders can occur, movement disorders, cancers, a lot of different developmental disorders can occur, and we use the zebrafish as a model organism. Genetics of the zebrafish is very comparable to human development. We have about 70 to 80% similarity in the genetics of development. A lot of the pathways, a lot of the genes involved in development are shared between fish and humans. Right now in the lab, we are using the fish to take a look at development of the stem cell compartments in the intestine. There are committed stem cells. They produce the cells that line the intestine. And within the adult intestine, there is a continuous turnover of those cells. The food passing through, the mixing, and the digestive enzymes create a really hostile environment for the cells that are lining the intestine. And so they wear out. They are actually programmed to die within about 5 to 7 days. And so there has to be replacements of those cells. And so at the very base of all the villi that are lining the intestine, there are stem cell compartments. And in the adult, they're well established. They are controlled. There are cells that regulate how they divide, when they divide, how many they produce. There's been not much done on where they come from, the development of those stem cell compartments. And we have become interested in how those compartments develop. We are right now taking a look at some of the cells that may, you know, that seem to be involved in control of when the, or how those compartments form. We are working on trying to figure out exactly how those cells control the formation of that stem cell compartment.